So Bernie Sanders' surge continues. He is leading in Wisconsin. He's closing the gap in Nevada. This is just amazing. Like, I'm looking at the numbers come in, and more each day, it dawns on me that we could literally win this and get a Bernie Sanders presidency. How amazing is that? So I want to talk about his numbers, because I think that after all of the bad news that we've been bombarded with, all of the smears and attacks, you have to understand that regardless, the hard work that you're doing, the time you're putting in, canvassing and phone banking for Bernie Sanders, guess what? It's paying off. Because guess who just surged to first place nationally, surpassing Joe Biden, according to a CNN poll? Bernard Sanders. And their headline actually says that he has surged to first place, believe it or not. And if you look towards the column on the left here of this graph, Bernie now leads with 27%, which is a 7-point increase since December, which is the last time that CNN conducted this poll. Joe Biden is now in second with 24%, dropping by 2 points since December. Warren is now in a distant third place, also dropping 2 points since December. And Pete Buttigieg is now at 11%, although he did rise 3 points overall, basically, you know, competing for third place with Elizabeth Warren. Now, that's not the only good poll that I want to share with you, but before I talk about the next poll, I just have to say, one of our most important arguments, and I think a real way that we can actually flip Biden supporters to Bernie Sanders, is by emphasizing Bernie Sanders' electability. And we just got a new poll from SurveyUSA that proves us right. According to this poll, as Newsweek reports, Bernie Sanders now leads Donald Trump out of all 2020 candidates by the widest margin. And I want to go to this tweet here because I think it lays out the data really nicely. So as you can see, Bernie Sanders beats Trump by 9 points overall, and Biden still beats Trump, albeit by 7 points. Now, it also shows that Bloomberg, Buttigieg, and Warren beat Trump by 7, 3, and 3 points respectively. And additionally, it shows that Andrew Yang beats Trump by 2 points, while Tom Steyer ties with Trump, and both Klobuchar and Gabbard lose to Donald Trump with 2 and 5 points respectively. So when it comes to electability, now is the time when we make our case for Bernie's electability loudly, because we now have a crucial piece of evidence, a recent poll that shows he does the best against Donald Trump. Now, what people need to realize is that we all have to assume Trump will run the dirtiest campaign imaginable, and he's going to eat into the lead that all of the Democrats have. So what we have to do is give ourselves the biggest possible cushion and assume that maybe Trump will knock a Democrat down by 4 points, right? So it makes sense to go with the person with the widest lead against Donald Trump, Bernie Sanders, and not just because the numbers say this. Also, substantively, you can really argue the case that Bernie has what it takes to turn out a wide set of voters that don't normally show up. He has the youth vote on lock. How did Barack Obama win in 2008? He got young people and disaffected voters out. That's the ticket. That's how you beat Donald Trump. Joe Biden isn't going to energize anyone. So if you want to win, you need someone who can energize the base. That is the crux of Bernie's electability argument, I think, in addition to these polls. So do not forget to cite this poll when you are making that case. Now, on top of that, what I think arguably matters the most is how Bernie Sanders is doing in early states. And as this tweet from the Morning Consult points out, Biden is technically still leading overall in early states at 26%, even though he is down a point. Now, Bernie Sanders, thankfully, is catching up overall with 23% to Joe Biden's 26%. He gained 4 points overall. Now, here's why I think we can win over some of Joe Biden's supporters, especially using that electability argument. So a plurality of Joe Biden supporters at 28% would go to Bernie Sanders because he is their second choice. And 37% of Warren supporters also have Bernie as their second choice. So we have a real opportunity to win over some of Joe Biden and Elizabeth Warren's supporters by stressing electability, because as they fall in the polls, this data by the Morning Consult indicates that it's Bernie Sanders who's going to benefit from that. And this is also really important considering, you know, caucus states, right? Because if you have a candidate that doesn't meet that 15% threshold, then you have to caucus for someone else. So people then go to their second choice. Bernie is going to benefit from two major candidates, two of the other frontrunners, if they don't reach that threshold. Now, I assume that in most cases, Joe Biden, probably Elizabeth Warren, will meet that threshold. Pete Buttigieg, you know, it's up in the air. But we're looking really good, although I will say that there is area for opportunity. And according to Real Clear Politics polling averages, when you look at Iowa, Biden currently is leading overall by about 3.7 points. Now, I don't want you to get too, you know, down and feel discouraged because of this. Remember that in 2016, Bernie Sanders overperformed the polls by about 4 points. So this doesn't mean that he's going to lose. It just means that we can win, but we want the largest possible margin of victory ever, so we can improve our odds, you know, going into other primary states. Now, in New Hampshire, Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders are virtually tied, with Bernie having a slight lead over Joe Biden by about a point. And in Nevada, we have a really strong opportunity here, since Biden and Elizabeth Warren are consistently dropping, but Bernie Sanders is holding pretty steady. Remember that Nevada is also a caucus state. Now, in South Carolina, well, we'll just say that we need the momentum, all the momentum that we can get, that we will hopefully have if Bernie Sanders can win Iowa and New Hampshire. I think that's really the only way that we can win South Carolina, or at least not get beaten in South Carolina, as was the case last time. So I do want to stress that Bernie doesn't have Iowa and New Hampshire on lock. You have to put in the work. If you have time this weekend, please make some calls for Bernie Sanders. But I want you to feel optimistic, cautiously so, but encouraged, because Bernie wouldn't be in this position, especially considering all of the establishment attacks and media smears, had it not been for you. Not only is the coalition from 2016 back, but he has expanded his voter base. And this is something that you did. If you're watching this video, any way that you have engaged, anything that you have done to contribute, even if it's just a dollar, you have done this. So I really want you to not let that fact be lost on you. You and all of us have contributed in some way to Bernie Sanders' strong numbers. And we have a real chance of electing a Bernie Sanders president. And as I talk about this, I get chills. Like, it's almost unbelievable. And after I was so devastated after 2016, I don't want to get my hopes up. So when I say be optimistic, be cautiously optimistic, because you never know what types of curveballs are going to be thrown our way. But understand, we have done so much. And win or lose, I think that we can all rest assured knowing that we tried everything we can to win and be victorious. We're certainly in a better position in 2020 than we were in 2016. And holy shit, guys, we might win this thing.